Well, we have a story now of a truly remarkable athlete.
That's right. Jonathan Bick from Sacramento getting ready to compete in a triathlon in Germany. And if that's not hard enough, Jonathan is an amputee above the knee as well. Jonathan, first of all, tell us exactly you're working for SMUD and had a pole come down.
Right. I was working for SMUD. I was actually coming over from SBC.
Right.
And I was up about 40 feet in a training accident. Fell from the pole from about 40 feet and dislocated the leg and had an artery issue. They weren't able to save it.
And so this was only 2 years ago.
Yeah, about 2.5 years. Yeah.
I don't know. I don't think I'd even be getting out of bed at this point.
Yeah.
You're going off and doing something really incredible. So
yeah.
Tell us a little bit about how this leg allows you to continue being really athletic.
This is my everyday leg. I have three for what I do. This is what I use for work. Mm-hmm. I coach my little girls' soccer team. I do everything in this one. My bike leg is right here, attached actually to the bike. And then my running leg is here. So each one has its own special functions and allow me to do all the different parts of the triathlon.
So did you obviously faced a decision to make once you had the amputation. It's like, do I go forward with my normal life? And you clearly decided in a big way to do that.
Yeah, it wasn't much of a decision. I didn't really see any way but kind of going forward with it.
Okay.
It's been inspiring to me. The whole ordeal. So
this leg, how is this different than that leg?
This actually just used to have a hydraulic chamber, and this one does now. But they removed it over at hangar, so it's totally free swinging. You don't mm-hmm. want any resistance on the bike, so that it's not fighting against you with your pedal strokes. This one has some resistance in it, so that it will draw the leg back forward for you. I have to generate a whole lot of force to come back forward
right.
with my hip flexors, so that helps a lot with that.
And so the triathlon you're going to in Germany is what?
It's World Championships. There's going to be all the professionals. It's a big qualifier for the Beijing Olympics. Triathlon's not in the Paralympics yet, maybe someday, so it's not really so much for us, but it's our World Championships, all different levels of amputations.
Yeah, wheelchair. Well, it's only been in the traditional Olympics for, you know, the last
right.
8 years.
Right.
So that's, it's still pretty new to that one,
too. They've
been
working on it pretty much ever since. So.
Wow.
Where are you stronger? Some people, when they overcome something like this, you become stronger in different parts of your body.
Well, definitely my good leg.
Okay.
Yeah, it's having to do, I don't even know how much work, probably at least 60, 70% more work
okay.
than it used to.
Did you do triathlon before this?
No.
Wow,
no. I've always been
amazing.
Athletic, but triathlon's new to me. So.
That's very
and
cool.
And a good
best
soccer
of luck.
Coach, too.
Yeah, that's to be seen.
Yeah.
You doing a little training this morning?
Yeah, I've got a bike ride later today.
All right, Eileen, what's the forecast like for Jonathan as he heads out for a little bike ride?
You know, tell Jonathan to make sure he gets in as early as possible.
Yeah.
Any
she
kind
says, go
of
now.
Especially the next couple of days.